All right, Shalom Akim. I want to start off by giving all praises to y'all, Bashim Yahushai. Double honors to the apostles and elders that great millstone that rule well. And salutations to the hopeful elect that's pushing this word in sincerity and truth across the four corners of the earth, you know. And I'm just back, you know, with another quick lesson, you know, about the mercy of the Most High, man. About the mercy that he's going to bestow on not only the hopeful elect, but the rest of the nation of Israel as well, man. You know, of course, y'all going to have to perish on this side because you don't want to come into the truth, or you're not allowed. Actually, you're not allowed to come into this truth. The prophecy has to be fulfilled that 2/3 of the nation be cut off and die. But even with that being said, the Most High is still merciful enough to bring you all back in the kingdom, you 2/3, you know, and let you, you know, live for eternity as well, man, and live in peace in the kingdom of heaven as well, man. Like, the Most High's power, it's like the Most High's mercy is just as great as his wrath, man. All right, and he's only going to show that mercy to the nation of Israel, man. All right, you Negro, Latino, Native American, Seminole, Indian. But I'm going to get into the scripture, and it's Psalms 85 and 2. It says, "Thou hast forgiven the iniquity of thy people. Thou hast covered all their sin." Salah. All right, and that's it's talking starting with the elect, man. Now, that's not for brothers to be, you know, wicked with it and just bank on the fact that, you know, I'm the elect, so I can do what I want, all right? Because if you got a mind state like that, you're not the elect, man. That's wicked, man. But that mercy is, you know, for the things that maybe we haven't gotten right about ourselves yet, or, you know, we putting forth an effort, but we haven't shook it completely, you know? All the times, you know, it's the you know, things in this society, you know, such as work, man, such as, you know, a lot of things, man, may make us go off. Maybe we can't keep the Sabbath, you know what I mean? Because we got to work, man. You know, maybe it's a sit down and brothers can't make it because, you know, they working the same, man. All right? All the times that we go off and we fall short, man, Lord willing, we be elect. Those sins are covered, man, because he chose us from the foundation of the world, man. All right? This is verse 3. "Thou hast taken away all thy wrath. Thou hast turned thyself from the fierceness of thy anger." All right? Turned yourself from the fierceness of thine anger. Because when you look at slavery, that hardcore bondage we was in, for you Southern Kingdom, man, you Negro, West Indian, Haitian, man, that was anger, man. That was wrath. That was true wrath, man. All you damn Jakes that be getting mad and thinking you be on the warpath, catch a couple bodies and whatnot. But that was true wrath, man. To uproot a whole nation and torture them. Alright, but the scriptures say he turned away from that wrath. This is a future prophecy in Psalms 85. He turned away from that wrath. This is what we're going to be saying and how we're going to be praising him in the kingdom of heaven for all the things that he's done for us, man. Alright, and you Northern Kingdom too, man. The conquistadors and the Spaniards torturing y'all. Alright, so-called white man, so-called European man coming over here from, Europe, of course, and punishing you goddamn Native and Seminole Indian, all right? That was all the wrath of the Heavenly Father, man. When you think about those things that was done to us, you know, in our minds, you know, in the world, you know, it was like, those were atrocities, you know? Like, how could so-called white man be so wicked? You know, which he is, but when you really dig deep into it, that was the Most High being angry with his children and punishing them for not listening to him. All right? But all that wrath, that fierce anger and that wrath that he had upon us at that point in time is going to be replaced with kindness and mercy in the kingdom of heaven. All right? Because his wrath, I'm just like, his mercy is just as great as his wrath, man. So, you can't even imagine how merciful he's going to be when we're in the kingdom of heaven, man. All the things that he has in store for us, man. If he could take it to that extreme, I mean, if you look at the extreme of his wrath, all right, and you can't even really imagine the extreme of his mercy, man, all right? Scripture says we're going to be singing upon our beds, man. You got to be happy as hell to wake up, yawn, and then just start singing praises to Yahweh Shem Yahushua, man. All right? We headed to paradise, man. Alright. It says, "Turn us, O Yahweh, of our salvation, and cause thine anger toward us to cease. And that's what he's gonna do. Alright? His anger is gonna cease, man. He's gonna forgive everybody. Alright? Like I said, 2/3 gotta die, but everybody's gonna be forgiven eventually, man. Alright? Though your sins be red as scarlet, they shall be made white as snow. Most I gonna forget all that bullshit we was doing, man. You know? It says, wilt thou be angry with us forever? Wilt thou draw out thine anger to all generations? Alright? No, he won't, man. Alright? Our iniquity is at an end, man. Alright, we on our way out of here. You know what I mean? So the Most High is not gonna be angry. Even you 2/3, man. He's not gonna be angry with y'all forever. He's about to fuck y'all up right quick though. But he ain't gonna be angry forever, man. Most High ain't gonna hold no grudge against his children forever, man. Just like you wouldn't do, man. Might be mad at your children, man. But in due time, show him mercy to balance out that wrath that you have for him, man. You know, and that's the same thing the Heavenly Father is gonna do. Alright? It says, wilt thou not receive, Selakia, wilt thou not revive us again, that thy people may rejoice in thee? Show us thy mercy, O Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, and grant us thy salvation. Alright? And that's what you see, hope for the elect that's on these street corners. Alright, that's, we already saying that, man. We already begging the Most High for salvation. We already begging him to revive us, that we can rejoice in him. I mean, we rejoicing in him in captivity, man. Think about that, man. We going through hell and we still rejoicing, y'all, Bashim Al-Shah, man. How much more when we in paradise, man? We just gonna be praising the Most High for his mercy, man. Alright? It's verse 8. I will hear what the Most High, Yahweh Bashim Al-Shah, will speak. For he will speak peace unto his people and to his saints. But let them not turn again to folly. Alright? That's what he's doing through us right now. For he will speak peace unto his people and to his saints. Man, we speak in peace for him. Not for him, but he's using us to speak to you all, you dumbass 2/3. But we speak in peace, man. I mean, you get rebuked too, but shit. At the end of the day, we're telling you, we're giving you the keys to the kingdom, man. Through the spirit and power of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, man. But y'all don't want to do nothing but buck up against us, but it's okay, man. Because, you know, in due time, you're going to see the power of Yahweh Hashem Yahushua. Alright, but it ain't gonna be his tender mercies. It's gonna be his extreme wrath that you 2/3 is gonna see, man. Y'all gonna get brought back into remembrance of how the Most High dropped bodies. Alright, all you nigga woman that come out there and you talk shit, you gonna get put in your place, man. Just like you so called tough niggas, man. Everybody gonna bow down, man. Everybody gonna hit both knees, man. Alright, but the elect, they gonna get delivered up out of here, man. Lord willing, myself and you brothers that's pushing his word and sincerity and truth are in that number. Alright? Because we've received the word, man. We received the peace, man. We going through hell, but we still got that hope, man. He gave us that hope, man. That faith. Y'all niggas just walking around here aimlessly, man. Just walking up and down the street being niggas, man. That's it. That's all you niggas do, man. We like, you be downtown, man. You see the same niggas every week, man. Same broke ass niggas, same dusty ass bitches walking up and down the street talking shit to us, man. Alright? But hey, every idle word, man, alright, shall be accounted for, man. Hey, Most High, hey, all that shit y'all talking, y'all not talking shit to us, man. That's why, you know, brothers done been in this troop like a little while now, you know, and you get to the point where shit don't even matter, man. Like, I'm not the one who's going to judge you, you know what I mean? I'm just relaying the message of who's going to kill you. And that's Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, man. Alright? And it says, but let them not turn again to folly, man. Don't go back in the world, man. All you niggas that fell out of this, man. Man, how could you be so naive, man? How can you not know that the Most High coming for you, man? You talked all that shit for years, man. So that mean you was bullshitting, man. You ain't believing Yahweh Hashem Yahushua. He gonna require that of you. All you niggas that fell out of this truth, it's gonna be required of you, man. Cause you worse than a 2/3, man. You at least a 2/3 just say, you know, they completely 100% say, fuck that, I ain't with that. You faked it for years, man. That's worse. So the Most High gonna come get y'all for that, man. All you niggas, alright? You niggas even in the camp that I'm in, GMS, Feed the Flock, Cleveland, man. Niggas that fell out of this camp. Alright, Most High gonna smoke your ass, nigga. It don't matter whether you went back in the world or you went to some wayward doctrine. You getting smoked, nigga. I hope you come across this video, man. Alright. It says, surely his salvation is nigh to them that fear him, that glory may dwell in our land. If you lead the truth, man, you don't fear the Most High, man. You don't fear him, man. Alright, it's only to the ones that fear him, man. Salvation is near the ones that fear him, man. Alright, that do his work, that follow his law, statutes, and commandments to the best of their ability. And even when they fall, man, and they go off, man, they dust themselves off and they get back up, man, and keep going. Cause they know ain't nothing else in this world important but Yahweh Bar Shem Yahushua, man. But I guess you fallout niggas getting fear the Most High. So salvation ain't nowhere near your ass, man. Since mercy and truth are met together, righteousness and peace have kissed each other, man. Alright, mercy and truth are met together, man. Alright. This truth is gonna bring forth the mercy, man. Doing the work, man. Just like the apostles and elders said, man. If you want salvation, do what they're doing, man. And that's what we took heed to that, man. Alright? We hold the truth within our hearts, man. Alright? And hopefully that mercy is bestowed upon us, man. Alright? Righteousness and peace have kissed each other, man. Alright? Because us being on this path, this path of righteousness, all right, because none of us are completely righteous, but being on this path of righteousness is going to bring forth peace for the elect, man, and ultimately the whole nation of Israel. But I'm talking about on the first go-round, man. Like, if you, let's say you've been hooping all your life, man, you this draft night, man, you don't want to go in the second round, man. You want to go, you know what I'm saying, top 10, man. Alright, that's how we feel. We want to be that top 144, man, in this draft, man. This salvation, this draft, this salvation draft, man, for lack of a better term, man. Alright. It says, truth shall spring out of the earth. And that's what you're seeing on the street corner. Alright, truth done sprang out of the earth. And how did that happen, man? Through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bar Shem Yahushua. There's only truth on the earth right now, man. Alright. Righteousness, it's like it. And righteousness shall look down from heaven. And the Most High is looking upon this truth, man. He's looking upon the brothers. Alright. That are, you know, sincere, man. Preaching his word in sincerity and truth, man. He's looking down on that, man. Can't fool the Most High, man. Alright, you out there just going through the motions and whatnot, man. That's how niggas fall out. That's how you always know a nigga about to fall out, man. He just going through the motions. He ain't got that fire no more. It ain't, you know what I'm saying? Cause you can tell when a brother just love his truth, man. He just love preaching the word, man. Alright? Like the Apostle to Harvey saying, you niggas that always got your hands in your pocket, man. You ain't fit for this, man. It's really war. It's just it ain't really popped off to maximum effect yet. So niggas get comfortable. You know, and they start thinking, you know, this is just, I could come out and talk on Sunday, Saturday, whatever your allotted day is that you brothers go out, man. Not knowing if this could pop up at any time, man. Esau could pull up with 5 vans at any time, draw down and throw you in them. Now you, any time we out there, man, this could pop off any time, any camp you at, man. Esau could just draw down on you. Scripture says it's going to be a great insurrection against them that fear the Lord. They gonna come for us, man. So if you out there just going through the motions, man, go home, man. Alright, just go take the chip now, man. What you been wasting everybody's time for, man? Come on, man. It says, yeah, the Lord shall give that which is good, and our land shall yield her increase. Righteousness shall go before him, and shall set us in the way of his steps. Alright, so the Most High, he's gonna give us the land back, man. In Deuteronomy 28:68, that land that he said we would never see again, he's gonna give it to us again, man. Alright, the best thing about it this time is we gonna have a new heart, man. He gonna take away the stony heart and give us the fleshly heart, man, which is our minds, man. And we never gonna be able to go against him again. Thus, we never gonna have to go into captivity again. Alright, we ain't never gonna have to die again, man. So the Most High, that's mercy, man. Alright. He gonna make it where we can't even go against him, so he ain't never gotta do nothing to us again, man. Alright. So you know, I just wanted to come. Excuse me, but you know, with that quick lesson, man, by the Most High mercy, man. Alright, I hope that was edifying. Now I wanna give all praises to y'all, boy, Shem Yahushua. Double honors to the apostles and elders at Great Millstone that rule well. And salutations to the hopeful elect that's pushing his word in sincerity and truth across the four corners of the earth, all right? Shalom, Akim.